ready to match the star. Bob Barker, Brent Summers, Gary Berghoff, Rona Barrett, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Play as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rammer.
You are friendly, aren't you?
Yes.
We're getting more friendly all the time.
Good. I'm glad to hear that.
Good looking devil, you.
Don't touch me unless you love me. Kiss her right on the lips.
You heard you have to marry
know each other.
Okay, I guess she's ready, so let's get on with it, shall we?
Let's say hello to Shirley Erie and Linda Gill. All right. Shirley's our current champ. She won $5,600. And now she's going to be challenged by Linda. We found out a little bit about her yesterday. She's a last semester student. Is that right?
It sure is, I hope.
At USC.
Uh-huh.
And you keep changing your major every 20 minutes.
That's right.
And you're not married.
Oh, no.
You go
no kids either.
No kids either. You're trying to tell us you don't fool around. Is that it?
That's right.
Okay. Oh. All right, we'll begin this game right after we finish this message for you. Here we go. All right, here we go. I'll push this button and ask Linda to make a selection.
I'd like to try B, please.
B is what she wants. And that's what she's going to get.
Stands here. For boy, and that yes. spells poo.
Mrs. Rip Van Winkle said... My husband, Rip, slept for 20 years under the old oak tree before I finally decided to put him in a blank. That's what she said. You've heard of Mrs. Rip Van Winkle.
Uh-huh.
She said, my husband,
Rip,
slept for 20 years under the old oak tree before I finally decided to put him in a blank. Finished? Think very fast, don't you? And you trust your first instinct. That's good.
Very good.
Very good.
Terrific.
Everybody finished? So here we go.
Everybody's finished.
I can't...
Come on, Gary, slip it in the slot there. Now, Linda Gill. Mrs. Rip Van Winkle said, my husband, Rip... Have you ever read that story?
Vaguely.
Yes. He slept for 20 years under the old oak tree before I finally decided to put him in a...
Coffin.
In a coffin.
Right.
All right, Linda said coffin. You've read the Rip Van Winkle story, haven't you?
Yes, yes, I've lived it. I was under the impression, though, that this was a happy show, and so coffin didn't occur to me. And I'm under the impression this is a happy audience, so I'm sorry that what occurred to me
He's
has occurred
again.
To me.
He's threatening again.
And I said he was under the tree anyway. She picked him up and put him in the hammock.
Hammock.
Hammock. The people in the audience with good taste are applauding.
Yes. Now, Brett, speaking of good taste, here's Brett Summers.
Do you like my tie?
Yes.
I'm a sergeant.
You are.
Aren't I, Fanny?
No, you're
She's
a corporal.
She's not biting on it at all. No. It's her tie.
Yeah.
She has a lot of these swell ties. Anyway, you know that old expression?
What?
Shape up, honey, or you're going to a home. I said she put him in a home.
Put him in a home.
Yeah.
That's not bad. That's one thought. Yes, Gary.
I think
they
want
to put Fanny. I certainly hope that this is a match, because it certainly would have. I said a mausoleum.
A mausoleum.
Isn't that mean the same thing?
Yeah, that's the same thing. A crypt.
Yeah, sort of.
Rip slept for 20 years under the old oak tree before I finally decided to put him in a blank, and Linda said coffin. What did you say, Rona?
Well, I figured after 20 years of no action, the thing she should do is put him in a bed and try him out.
Put him in a bed. Put him in a bed. Finally decided to put him in a bed, she said. She, over here, Linda, said coffin. What do you say, sir?
He didn't die, darling.
He just fell asleep.
Really? He just had a little schluff for 20 years and woke up and said, oh, I've missed beat the clock.
Bed. Bed seems to be the answer. What do you say there, Fanny?
Well, I unfortunately said bed.
Bed for
you. Oh, well,
okay. So that's one for you, and now let's see how you do with your first round question, Shirley. Marge said, I left my bathroom window open during the big blizzard last night. This morning, I discover the Tidy Bowl man blanking in the tank.
Read it again.
I left my bathroom window open during the big blizzard last night. This morning, I discovered the Tidy Bowl Man blanking in the tank.
What a cute question.
See, the big blizzard left the bathroom window open. Then in the morning when she went in there, there was the Tidy Bowl Man blanking in the tank.
You have pretty cheekbones.
Thank you.
Wait a minute.
Oh, my glasses fell off.
The heritage from Genghis Khan.
That's true. Are they on straight?
Yes. You look very chic. Yes.
Your face is crooked.
Oh, I know.
I'm really worried, though. I've been here long enough. I'm beginning to understand, Brad.
Good. Okay. Everybody ready. We call on Shirley Erie. Marge said I left my bathroom window open during the big blizzard last night. This morning I discovered the Tidy Bowl Man blanking in the tank.
Frozen.
Frozening.
I said blanking. Well, we have to...
Freezing.
Okay, freezing is her answer. Freezing in the tank. Da-da-dee-da-dum, da-da-da-da-dum. Hello there, Bob.
Well, I'm not sure we looked in the same tank.
Really?
It was frozen, but he was ice skating.
Ice skating.
You mean it?
Yeah.
They mean it.
No, listen.
Bob. I'm going home. I'll never top that.
He gets one. There's one good answer and he loses his head. They'll get you when you give a wrong one. Okay, Brett.
Oh, whoopee for him. Well, of course, skating.
Skating, right. Gary?
Gee, I hope
I thought that was her answer.
No, you said skating. She said freezing.
He said skating. I understand her now.
Yeah, that's right. Now, Gary's on. Leave him alone.
Oh, I hope this is a match. I said... Because I really meant it to be. I said mausoleum. Is that meant?
No. That was the last round.
I said skating, I'm sorry.
Skating. Three skating so far, Shirley. This morning I discovered the Tidy Bowl Man blanking in the tank. What do you say to that?
Now, I got to stop you for a second. Because first I thought you said blanking, and then I thought I heard you say blank. So I wrote the right thing the first time, and then when you said the blank, so I then said the frozen. But I first had the freezing.
Wait a minute.
Oh, get on with it.
Past tense doesn't make any difference. It's a match.
You got a bell.
Oh, it's a bell.
Don't ride the bell.
You got it. She gives the right answer and she apologizes for it.
Right. Don't
what do you say there?
What's the question?
I've forgotten. I discovered the Tidy Bowl Man blanking in the tank. She said freezing.
Floating face down.
Floating face down.
Crushed with success.
Are you feeling...
I like that.
You see, instead of going to the psychiatrist and spending $50, he comes here and he works out his unresolved hostilities. That's exactly what he does. What do you say there, madam?
I say that Mr. Bob Barker's a wonderful person.
Yes.
And you know what? He is Indian blood. Has Marlon Brando given you anything, honey? Skiing
is another good one. Okay, so it's 1-1 at the end of round one, and round two coming up after this message. Okay, here we go with round two. Linda Gill, please make a selection.
A, please.
A. Last time you matched Gary, so everyone except Gary will participate in this. The psychiatrist said to his nurse, "Could you have a water hose ready for my next session? My patient thinks he's a blank."
Oh, honey, I got it.
Write it down.
Those psychiatrists. Don't give it to me.
Psychiatrist. Could you have a water bed? A water hose.
Ready for my next session.
I know where your mind is. And get it out.
Could you have a water hose ready for my next session? My patient thinks he's a blank. Did you hear that, Linda?
Sure did.
All right, you think about that for a moment. While Bob is finishing up, now he's ready, and we'll call on you. Psychiatrist said to his nurse, "Could you have a water hose ready for my next session? My patient thinks he's a..."
Gardener.
A gardener? See, this guy was sleeping for 20 years. All right. Now, Bob, she says, "Gardener, could you have a water hose ready for my next session? My patient thinks he's a gardener."
Things have been going so well today.
Yes.
Up till this point. The patient thought he was a camel.
A camel.
And needed the water. You are fair weather friends.
Fickle. Okay, Brett.
I do not begin to understand that answer, and I have given some strange answers
well,
in my
camels
head.
Often need water.
Don't explain
I mean,
it.
No.
All
right. Go.
Good gravy, Marie. No. He thought he was a fire.
The weirdos are applauding your answer.
Hi, weirdos.
Go, Gary.
Well, I don't write, but do you want to hear my answer?
Oh, you don't write. No. You know, you were the one she matched in the first round. Now we call her Rona Barrett. What do you say?
Well, only a person who would have a lot of problems would go to a psychiatrist, and therefore he would have to think he was a fire hydrant.
A fire hydrant. Haven't
Boo.
Picked up one gardener
answer,
yet
I
here.
Thought.
You like that answer?
I thought it was a wonderful
psychiatrist
thing.
Said there's could you have a...
Kissing blank again, kissing blank again.
Wait a minute. Fanny, I have to say something nice about you. Is there anything nice to say about you?
No.
I like you.
You're right in the middle there, Richard.
You're playing. I haven't had this much fun since they took a wisdom tooth out through my ear. Could you read the question, please?
The psychiatrist said to his nurse, could you have a water hose ready for my next session? My patient thinks he's a gardener, according to Linda. What do you say?
Thinks he's a pansy.
Good. Naturally.
Before I answer, I have an announcement to make.
What
Brett
is your announcement?
Brett Summers' wig is a Pekingese that once belonged to Ilona Massey, and I think it looks swell, don't
you? I hope your false eyelashes fall off, the bottom ones.
Oh, it's fun and games
this
time.
Fire. A match.
No gardeners, Linda. Okay, so now we go to you, Shirley, and you're in a good spot here because all you need is one to win another game. Everyone except Rona will play. Lois Lane said, now that Superman is old, he's retired from crime fighting. All he does all day is stand on the street corner showing off his shriveled blank. Aren't you sure you're not playing?
That's funny.
Lois Lane said, now that Superman is old, he's retired from crime fighting. All he does all day is stand on the street corner showing off his shriveled blank. You think about that? Listen, I gotta tell you something. My mother, the sweet, dear old lady that she is a little bit of a Mrs. Malaprop. And I went over there one day, and she says, do you know what I heard on the television today? I said, from whom? She says, from Ronald Berry. And then she gave me some kind of gossip. Somebody was divorcing. I said, who is Ronald Berry? She said, you know Ronald Berry. She's that woman who tells you everything that's going on. She got your name. She calls you Ronald Berry.
I don't want to tell you what a few other people call me.
But she loves you. Okay, here we go. Shirley Urey. Lois Lane said, now that Superman is old, he's retired from crime fighting. All he does all day is stand on the street corner showing off his shriveled blank.
Yes.
What's that?
Yes.
Yes. Hey, seven girls, they don't talk so plain.
Now that she mentions it, I saw him in the parking lot.
What did you say, sir?
Well, I said he was showing off his shriveled muscles.
Muscles. Yes. Okay. She's looking for a shriveled A.S.
Don't say it with a
tell you what
accent.
She's got here, honey.
What she
she's
got?
She's got a shriveled A.S. Here's the game. What do you got?
Yeah. Congratulations, there's another $100. That means you're up to $5,700. Stand by for a moment or so. Linda, we've got a gift for you, together with our thanks and the very best of wishes from Match Game 75. A pleasure to meet Linda Gill. Goodbye. Now, here it is again.
Feels good.
Feels good?
Yes.
Okay. She's going to have another go at the big money. She's done very well so far. She had a perfect round when she was up here the first time, won the $5,600, and she's going to go for it again. Let's see if it happens. We polled a recent studio audience, Shirley. We got their best response to this. Blank finger or blank finger? The answer they...
Fingers.
Oh, fingers. Oh, there's an S on it.
Is there an S on the end of that, honey?
Yeah, there is an S on the end of that. I didn't see it. It's not a shriveled S. It's just a plain S. And the
answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. The next one, $250, and the third, $100. Now, three of these people are allowed to help. Choose them one at a time.
Richard.
Butterfingers.
Butterfingers is one answer.
And Fanny.
Fanny.
Sticky Fingers.
Sticky Fingers.
And Gary.
Gary, have you got one?
Lady Fingers.
Lady Fingers. Okay, you got Lady Fingers, Sticky Fingers, and Butterfingers. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better one in your head?
Better Fingers.
Better Fingers.
Better. What did she say?
She says she's had better fingers in her head. It's a Butterfingers. Okay. All right. Butterfingers.
Well, that's the way it goes.
That's right. That's the one we're looking for, Butterfingers. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response. Sticky Fingers is the one that Fanny gave you. Okay, that may be a good omen for you, Shirley. Let's find out if Butterfingers is under the $250 response. Lady Fingers. Oh. Gary gave you that one. Okay, last chance for Butterfingers. Here's the $500 response. We got it. Shirley, you're up to $6,200. And here's another go at $5,000. Whom do you select?
Richard.
All right, Richard, you get ready to write. Shirley will face me. Here is the $5,000 question. Human blank. H-U-M-A-N. Human blank. Now, Richard is finished. Shirley, it's up to you to give us an answer which you think will match his. What do you say to this? Human?
Being.
Human being.
Being, auntie. Being.
She spelled it for me because she knows that I have a little difficulty understanding the English language as it's spoken where she is
in
from.
Tennessee.
In Tennessee. She says human being, B-E-N-G, gonna match you. Richard, what do you say to that?
Well, I just finished reading the Maki de Sade book, Human Bondage, and I also thought of human race, and I know you'll go back to him the next time. Now I wrote being.
Ah, congratulations. She said she's going to try and help out President Ford with all that money and put it in circulation and get this recession over with. Going to spend it. Okay. We're very happy for you, Shirley Yeary. You now have $11,200. And for you, dear friends, we've got this message. Now, if you're all set, Shirley, how do you feel? You feel all right now?
Yes.
Okay. Then we'll present your next challenger. Let's welcome Nana Sandler.
Hi.
Now, Nana, would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'd be glad to. I'm from Canoga Park, which is in the valley. And hi. And I have a husband that's very nice, and a teenage son who's a surfer. And my license plate is Klutz, and that tells the story.
Your license plate says Klutz on it?
Right.
Really? What klutzy thing have you ever done, a nice, dignified-looking lady
like
that?
You don't have all that time.
Really?
Right, but it's great on the freeway. They clear out.
Oh, I see.
Really, they just let me go.
There's a method to your madness,
right.
Okay, Nana, good luck to you. Here we go. Would you please make a selection?
A, please.
All right. Everybody, please. Rona Barrett's dead.
Oh, again?
She said, here's my wicked whisper for the day. She said, Charles Nelson Reilly isn't really in a Broadway play. Charles has been gone all this time because he's having a blank.
She said, Charles, there's so many terrific answers.
There's some
for that.
Terrific answers to this one.
But I suppose
I don't know any of them.
Charles, oh, yes,
could
you
I
do.
Who are we playing?
Rona Barrett said, here's my wicked whisper for the day. Charles Nelson Reilly, who usually sits in that seat, as you know, really isn't in a Broadway play. Charles has been gone all this time because he's having a blank.
Now, which contestant are we playing?
Nana Sandler.
Well, well may I discuss it with Nana?
No, no, you can't talk.
No, I can't.
No, no.
Yes, yes.
Nana,
yes.
No, you can't do that. Please. All right. Everybody finished in the lower tier?
10 answers.
Just pick one and let's go.
Well, I'm pick one and I'm going. Aren't I ready?
All right, Nana. Rona Barrett said, here's my wicked whisper for the day. Charles Nelson Reilly isn't really in a Broadway play. Charles has been gone all this time because he's having a...
facelift.
Facelift. That's one possibility. That was one of the good answers. Yes, Bob?
I will have her license plate after today. Vacation.
Vacation. That's a clutzy answer. They're telling it like it is, Bob. That was a rotten answer.
All right. None of you will become queen for a day.
Listen, I've been queen for a day. What do I want that to come for?
You've been queen for your whole life.
Show your answer.
Oh, no, I was going to, well, unfair, but you know.
Yeah.
I would have to then divulge who it was with. I said hair transplant. I'm sorry.
Hair transplant.
He's not coming back because he's having a ball.
He's having a good time. Now, here we go to Rona. What do you say there?
Well, I don't know if they'll accept it, but it's what I meant, a nip and tuck, a
nip
facelift.
And tuck. That's called a facelift in the vernacular.
Nip and tuck. What I call it every time I say
in
wicked whisper.
Yeah, that's right. A nip and tuck. That's what it is. So there's one for you, Nana.
The real Richard. Scam is he's having a baby.
He's having a baby. That's another good answer. Fanny?
Having a good time.
Having a good time. Okay, so it's one for you. Your question is yet to come, but first this is coming your way. Just time to say goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.